Welcome back to the conversation, and it's good to have you here. Each week at this time, we talk about your good health and measures you can take to make sure you maintain your good health or deal with issues you may be facing. This week, a little bit different, because we're going to discuss a little more in detail the coronavirus and how we may deal with it on a local level if it gets here, which, according to the CDC, it's not a matter of if we're going to deal with the coronavirus in the United States, but a matter of time as to when we deal with the coronavirus. It's now, of course, spread throughout big chunks of China, into Italy, Iran, and new cases springing up in Europe, and dozens of cases now have been confirmed in the United States. And I believe that if we had proper testing, we would probably have more confirmation of cases in the United States. But right now we have a testing issue, and not a lot of us have been tested. Joining me to take a closer look at this is Dale Jackson. He is the director of EMS and Preparedness at Sparrow Hospital. Dr. Jackson, welcome to the program.
Thank you, Steve. I'm happy to be here.
Good to have you here. All right, so when it comes to being prepared, obviously, Sparrow is a level one trauma center. It's the regional trauma center. You guys know how to deal with crises that come at you from different angles. You practice these things, I know. You practice for mass casualty events. This is a little different. How do you prepare for what could be a localized outbreak, could be part of a bigger epidemic or pandemic? What are your thoughts?
Well, Steve, that starts first with our great team. As I'd like to say, at Sparrow, we have a family of caregivers. We work at Sparrow, as you know, to make it Michigan's first choice in healthcare. And as you said, we're building upon our already established strength as a leading academic medical center and level one trauma center and emergency department. We are always prepared, no matter the time of day, night, weekend, or holiday, to respond to the community's needs. With regards to the coronavirus, we've enhanced some processes that we already have in place to screen and identify patients with flu-like symptoms or coronavirus-like symptoms. We check to see if they've had contact with anybody in the area where the virus is currently endemic, and especially in China where the outbreak began.
Right.
If you present and you have to any of our clinics or to our hospital with any of the symptoms of fever, runny nose, sore throat, cough, we have enhanced measures that we've put in place. One of the things that we have done is we've increased our signage. We've trained all of our personnel. There is a...
Let me ask you this, because this is one of the things that came up, Doctor. Now, this is important. Are you able to test for coronavirus directly? Because we know that the packaging and the testing kits that were sent out from the CDC were faulty, and they're trying to scramble, if you will, to get caught up and get out testing kits that will actually detect the coronavirus. It takes, apparently, from my understanding, some sort of a specialized kit. Are we prepared to do that?
Well, right now we only send tests if you meet certain specific CDC guidelines that have been put out. So if you have direct contact with somebody known to have the coronavirus, or you've come from Wuhan, China, the area in China where it's currently epidemic, then you will be identified throughout our screening process. We'll work with the local health department, who will provide us with the kits. The person or patient will be placed in appropriate isolation. All of their healthcare needs will be addressed. They'll be cared for adequately. And depending upon our coordination with the county health department in the state, we'll send samples, if appropriate, to the CDC for proper testing.
Fair enough.
We have that capability if it meets our screening criteria.
Okay, then that's important to know. Dr. Dale Jackson here, he's the director of EMS and Preparedness for Sparrow Hospital, the largest hospital for the region in southern Michigan here in the Lansing area. So let me ask you this. One of the things that I have come to understand about this coronavirus is obviously it's a respiratory illness. It can trigger pneumonia in patients. Pneumonia is often something that is dealt with in an intensive care setting. Is there a concern at all that you will have enough patients present, based on what we're hearing from the CDC, that you could have a challenge on having enough beds?
Yes, Steve, that's a good question. As you know, with flu, the majority of people who get the flu or coronavirus have mild to moderate illness. Many of them don't even need to seek specialized medical care and can care for themselves at home. Building off of the plans that we all put in place here at Sparrow and working with the state and our emergency preparedness partners, we have plans that we've enhanced. We're reviewing, we're drilling them now, that were actually born out of the 2009 H1N1 pandemic. We practice and drill what we call our surge capability. And if in the event that we have a larger number of seriously ill patients that require hospital beds, special respiratory treatment, special ventilators, we have the ability, working with our regional healthcare coalitions and our Bureau of Trauma and Emergency Preparedness, to call on those resources and meet the surge need, the capacity that our community might need in the event that the coronavirus did arrive in Michigan and we had more people sick than we see on a regular day. So, yes, we're prepared, and we have the capability to expand as needed.
And that is very good news. And, Doctor, I really appreciate you giving us some peace of mind here today. Dr. Dale Jackson is the Director of EMS and Preparedness for Sparrow Hospital. I'll give you the last word, Doctor. We've got about 20 seconds.
Yeah, thanks for that. I just want to say what a privilege it is to serve the physicians or as a physician serving our community, not only alongside our Sparrow family of caregivers, but in my role, we all collaborate with our local and state health department, our Tri-County Medical Control Authority, and our Region 1 Healthcare Coalition.
Yes,
and
sir.
Especially the men and women of our fire, rescue, and EMS agencies. Together, we provide the community members with compassionate care, and sometimes that's during times of the greatest need. It's a privilege, and so thank you for asking.